Hey everybody, this is Eric Clark's Travel Videos, and I'm here in Rome, Italy, and I'm in Via Farnese, which is a house, Farnese, and it used to be this house, and so all the art behind me and all the rooms are just, they've taken it all and put it in here, and it's an amazing museum now. And this one right behind me is a Raphael, and it is amazing. It's a little hot, but it still is amazing. Come on, I'll go show you what this whole place looks like. Bye, everybody. Okay, I got my ticket, and I'm going in, and this is Via Farnese Museum. And I've come by here a couple of 10 times, but I never wanted to spend the money. Oh my gosh. And I guess I should have. Oh my gosh, wow, wow. Yeah, that's amazing. Oh my gosh. Wow. Wow, wow. Look at that. That's crazy. Wow. Wow. So this was somebody's house at one time. Wow. Wow, wow. Those are tapestries, right? Is that a tapestry or is that a painting? Oh, it's a painting made to look like a tapestry. Excited about the rest of them. Wow. Wow. Look at that. Wow. Look at that ceiling. That's amazing. And these are pillars that open up to the outside. Can't even imagine. Wow. And that's all marble. And what does it say? Oh, that's the first floor that way. Wow. Look at the light holder. That's just an amazing in itself. What's in here? There's a Raphael in here too. And this ceiling's a little different. Wow. It's just amazing to walk through these doors and just see things like this back in the day. Imagine living here and having this. Wow. Wow, wow. Oh, look at those stairs too. Get out of here. That's amazing, huh? Yeah, wow, okay. I'm back to going up again, everybody. I'm not going down, up. But it's pretty. I guess this is bi-directional. It's an upper and a downer. Oh, that's a toilet. Okay, I don't need a toilet. Wow. Wow, look at the clouds outside. Those are real clouds. That's amazing. Well, let's go. go. This way or that way? Or that way? Well, I guess we'll go this way. Oh, there's that way too. So four directions. Wow. Oh my gosh. Can you imagine that being the hall to your bathroom? This looks like the stuff they have in Pompeii. One of the latest discoveries regarding the decoration of Villa Farnesina is represented in the grotesque motifs that complement the blah, 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 blah. Wow. Look at the grounds too. Just silly. An interesting way to do art on the wall. That's a chandelier. It's not as good as the one at Diana's house, but still amazing. Of a green black kind of motif. Now that's an interesting chandelier. So much to read here, we'd be here for a week. But this tells you all about the rooms and stuff, so I guess I will give you a second to hit pause. during the sack of Rome in 1527, a lax neck occupied the villa to face the frescoes on the walls with writings visible today. Oh, how crappy is that? Hit pause if you need to, everybody. That's not English. Okay. Huh. So imagine that this used to be on a wall inside of a Villa Farnesina, a house, a mansion, and you can see where they had written crap on the walls. See it there? And so then they tried to fix it. Yeah. How crappy is that? Huh. And so this is what it used to look like when they found it after the people had destroyed the rooms and defaced everything. And this is what it looks like today. Hiya. Amazing. Does this go up another level? It doesn't, does it? This is it. Downstairs is much more ornate, but these stairs are pretty magnificent. That's a pretty amazing view. Wow. Amazing. I want these stairs in my house. Actually, I don't want any damn stairs. I don't want to climb for anything. The mosaics on the floor look amazing. Not that I would take. Oh, here we go. Oh, that's a bookshop. I don't want a bookshop, though. It looks like everybody just hangs out in here. These windows open up to the outside. So back in the old days, this would just be an open forum. An open room. Is amazing. Wow. Hmm. Wow, wow. It is amazing. I agree. Wow. Medusa. Crazy amazing. This was somebody's house. Silly. Okay. Villa Farnese. Wow. And there's just tons of things to read here, but again, we'd be here for hours. The most astonishing discovery was the pigment currently known as Egyptian blue, the oldest artificial blue pigment whose production dates back to around 3100 BC and composed by mixtures of silicate and calcium and copper. This result was at first sight disconcerting in that it usually thinks the pigment is okay. It is nevertheless the Egyptian blue, blah, 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 blah. That is just, wow. Wow, wow. I guess I should let you read all this, huh? Because, I mean, there's just stuff on every side here. The detailed re-examination of the surface of the fresco. Can you read this one? Wow. Wow, wow. So here it is, the loggia of Galita. The loggia is named after Raphael's fresco, the triumphant of Femis. So is that done by Raphael? I think that's what that says. So where is that one? That's that one right there. Pretty amazing. I like how they have some that are like this one up here is black and white, kind of almost. What a room. What an amazing place. Wow, everybody. Okay, I should have came in here years ago. Okay, kick me. Or at least pinch me a little. Wow. Wow, wow. And that is pretty. Keep looking at it and not the camera, sorry. So if I drift off, you understand, because I'm enjoying the picture, not enjoying the camera. Wow. Okay, everybody, that's it. Wow.